Hello and welcome to another edition of Capper Comparison Picks. My name is Ranj, and today I will be doing Belarus Premier League soccer picks for Wednesday, tomorrow morning, April 8th. There's two games for the Belarus Premier League, one at 10:30 and the other one at 12:30 Eastern United States Eastern Time. Okay, first of all, let's look at tomorrow starts match day 4 of 10. So each team has only played, thus far, only played 3 games. As for match day 3 of 10, which was last Sunday, it ended for all the teams. I went 6-2 of all 8 games. I picked 6 correct and 2 of them I had wrong. So not bad. I went through the scores, if you follow along through the Belarus videos that I've done, I went through the scores daily, but I didn't go through the Sunday games. So I'll go through them briefly right now. Energetic BGU or BDU, that stands for Belarus State University. They won 2-0 against number one ranked Minsk. I had picked them for Sunday. Then I also picked Vitebsk to beat Smolvichi STI, and they did. They won 0-1. And the game I lost, I had Ilok beating Slutsk, but Slutsk won 2-3 against Ilok. That was match day 3 of 10, 6-2 overall. I'll take that every match day. Come out on top, okay? So today's matches, we have Slavia Mozyr, currently number 5, taking on Bates Borisov, currently number 11, okay? I found it's not Bate. That was like, there was this question, what is it, Bate or Bate? It's Bate. It's an acronym for Bosnian Automotive and Tractor. Hold on, I have it highlighted. Or, I'm sorry, not Bosnian. Borisov. Borisov Automotive and Tractor Electronics. That's what Bate. That's why it's like Bate Borisov. Borisov is a city. You know, because of this stay inside, you know, stay home, save lives, we've been doing a lot of homeschooling. But I'm incorporating my hobbies with schooling. Brandon, what's the capital of Belarus?
Minsk.
What was that?
Minsk.
Minsk, correct. What language do they speak in Belarus?
Russian.
Russian. How many people are on a soccer team?
11.
11. How many positions are there?
4.
What are they?
Defender, attacker, goalie, and midfielder.
What's another word for defender?
Fullback.
Correct. Did you hear to see that? Today we did for homeschooling. We did a little soccer study. We did some for physical ed education. We went outside and did some dribbling drills and some shots on goal, which was me. Then I threw him in goal and I took some shots on him. Still got to work on his footwork, but we're getting there. Anyway, back to these games. Sorry to go off topic briefly. Let's get right into this. Slavia Mozyr versus Bosnian Automotive and Tractor Electronics. Why do I keep saying Bosnian? It's Borisov. It was Slavia Mozyr versus Bates Borisov. Borisov Automatic and Tractor Electronics. Okay. The last game for Slavia Mozyr was a win versus Dynamo Brest. That was a 1-2. I'm sorry. That was a loss. I don't know why I put win. That was definitely a loss. Lost to Dynamo Brest 1-2. Okay. the last game for Bate was they had a victory against Rubrest. Or Rookbrest, I don't know if the K is silent. And that score was 1-0. That was their last games they played. Now, key players to look out. Since I'm only doing two games today, I've been trying to only do one player per team. But because there's a Slavia Mozyr has two players on the league leading scorers presently. And like I said, there's only been three games. So they have two guys, so I had to put them both. We have Andriy Chukli, I'm not sure, but he has two goals on the season so far. And so does Nikita Melnikov. Now, Nikita Melnikov, he has two goals. Another ad note, he had the last game head-to-head against Bate Borisov. He had two goals in that game by itself. That was during the Super Cup championship or something like that, I do believe I read. So that's two players for Slavia to look out for this so far this season. Over here we have the two players I picked for Bate. They both have a goal apiece. One's guy's name is Stanislav Dragoon. Stan Dragon has one score. Last season he was in 27 appearances he had 14 goals. So he's pretty good. And Maxim Skavish. Now, if you've noticed, if you've watched any of the other Belarus videos I put out, I did mention they have an Icelandic guy too. His name is Willem Willemsson. He's also got a goal, but you know, I don't want to fill the thing with all these different players. So in 25 appearances, he has 10 goals. So, there you go. Now, as for other team talent, there are zero national players on Slavia and 10 foreign. Okay, so that'll give you an idea what kind of talent. Now, I've been through this before, discussed what's a big deal. Well, national team players, of course, are the best in the nation. So you have to achieve, it's an accomplishment, you have to achieve that. And as for foreign players, they are being paid to come play they're being played to come to Belarus and play soccer. Therefore, they got to have more talent than the average player, understandably. As for Bate Borisov, they have 11 national team players and 8 foreign. Now, looking at it from stepping back and comparing these teams one side by side, apparently Bate has more talent because they have more national team players, 0 over here, and 8 foreign. So, you know, they have 19 confirmed high-quality players to their 10. I'm just throwing that out there as a little, you know, that's how my brain works when I'm picking these teams I don't really know much about. But I'm learning more and more every day. I love it. It's incredible. Head-to-head, chronologically, head-to-head, they've been, Bate, back in April, won 1-2. Then they also won back in August 4-0. However, Slavia Mozyr won the most recent in March 28th. They won 2-1. And that's the game. This is where Melnikov scored 2 goals against Bate. The only person that scored in that head-to-head for Bate was that Willem, the Icelandic kid. Willem Willemsson. So take that into effect. Now, the odds, these odds are from this morning. I don't know, when I got looking at them, it was, I don't know, 8 o'clock this morning, I looked up these odds. They have since changed, but I didn't write them down. It's just a pain in my ass. So, the odds this morning, Slavia Mozira was plus underdog at plus 267 playing at home.
Brandon. What?
Bait Borisov is at a plus 106. So, they're the favorite. And that's because, you know, they've got these victories. Plus, Bait, they are the Super Cup, what was it, Super Cup champs or something? I don't know, but it's, last year, finished off number 2. Slavia finished off number 8. That's probably why they're favored. The draw is at plus 234 if you choose to draw. Over-under is set at 2.5. Over, minus 101. Under, minus 119. But because these guys are hot coming off this victory over Bait, where Melnikov scored 2 goals, and they're playing at home, and they got the bigger plus number than the underdogs. I love taking the underdogs on the win. I'm going to take Slavia Mozir for the upset against the automobile and tractor electronic team, Borisov. I'm taking Slavia Mozir. As for the over-under, we have 4 times of the 5 posted games, it's gone over, and only once has it gone under. In the 5 displayed games up here, they're just random. You know, the last game went under for Bait, the last game for Slavia went over, and then the head-to-heads all went over, all 3 of them. The most recent head-to-head. So I'm taking the over. I'm going to play the over, and I'm playing Slavia Mozir to win. That's where my money's going to go. Okay, that's 10:30 tomorrow morning. So, place your bets on that. Now, at 12:30, lunchtime show. Like I mentioned before, there's definitely a way to stream these. I guess I didn't sign up, but Bet365 said you can, if you sign up through them. I don't go through them. I go through a different betting site. But it says you can stream the games live. But I did mention on YouTube, the developer, you can't watch the games live, but you can watch his reaction to him watching the game, and he commentates it. You just got to make sure the kids are out of the room, because he throws that F word around a lot.
Oh, fucking knock. You kicked him right in the fucking throat.
And, you know, it's just a little too much cursing with my children around. But anyway, moving on. We have Dynamo Brest. They're currently number 10. Their record, current record for this is 1-1-1. Same with Shakhtar Soligorsk. Both are 1-1-1 on the season. But last year, 2019, Dynamo Brest went 23-6-1, finished in first place. Shakhtar, not too shabby. They finished 20 wins, 5 draws, and 5 losses. They finished in third place. Odds, Dynamo Brest, they're both at plus numbers. But Dynamo Brest are the underdog, are the favorite, I'm sorry, because they're playing at home. They're at plus 134. Still favorite. And then over here, Shakhtar Soligorsk are underdogs, but that's a nice plus 234 if you take Shakhtar to win. Money line. The over-under set at 2. The draw, if you pick the draw, it's at plus, it'll pay out plus 202, meaning $100 bet, you'll win $202 off that bet. Over and under is set at 2, over is at minus 101, under minus 119. And here we go. Last game for Dynamo Brest was a win versus Slavia, right over here. A win versus Slavia Mozir. And that was 1-2. For Shakhtar Soligorsk, that was a draw versus Nemo Grodno. Nemo Grodno. You know, the Belarus is a landlocked country. You got Russia to the east, Poland to the west, Ukraine to the south, and up north we have Latvia and Lithuania. That's a little bit more knowledge I learned today during homeschool. Keep the education up. Knowledge is power. Okay, where was I? Niemann, Rogno. Oh, that was a draw 0-0. Okay, that was their last game. Okay, key players to keep a lookout for. I put two on each team, you know. I've mentioned this guy before, Gabby Keke. He's a defender. He's got one goal on the season. He's from Cameroon. One goal on the season. Defender. He's pretty good, though. I like him. Artem, another guy they have that's good to keep an eye out for. His name is Artem Malevsky. Or Malevsky. Malevsky. He's got a goal on the season. Over here, key players to look out for on Shakhtar Soligorsk, we have a midfielder. The only score, I mean, these are the only people that have scored on the teams thus far. We have Dmitry, Podstrelov. He's got a goal. And another midfielder, Georgie. I mentioned this guy before on the last Shakhtar Soligorsk game. Georgie Diazmidze. Diazmidze. What's up, baby? And he's got a goal, too. Okay. As for other talent on the team, Dynamo Brest has 11 national players and 7 foreigners. Dynamo Brest is no joke. They, you know, finished number one last season. They're top dogs. But Shakhtar Soligorsk, they're not slouches either, with 9 national team players and 9 foreigners. So if you look at it in talent wise, it's kind of even. You know, you got 18 established players here, you know, confirmed to be good, and 18 confirmed to be good. That's how I look at it. You know, 18, you know, and you can ask my son, how many people are on a soccer team? 11. it's so much fun. Okay. Here's some added notes. Dynamo Brest and Shakhtar Soligorsk. Let me read this quick thing for you. They're rivals, and I'll explain why. The organized groups, fan groups, are politically motivated. The fans for Dynamo Brest are called the Blue White Devils. They are politically right wing, okay? And they are in good contact with fans of Dynamo Minsk and Bates Borisov. They're all, I'm assuming, they're right wing politically motivated, like fans, you know, they're right wingers in politics. Now, their rivals are teams such as Gomel, Dnipro Mogilev, who is not in the tournament right now. They got dropped to a smaller league. Shakhtar Soligorsk, Slavia Mozyr. So this is a little rivalry here too. Belshina Bobrusk, Torpedo Minsk, and Niemann Grodno. Now they're all left-wing political fans. I found that to be pretty interesting. I didn't know that, you know, a little bit more knowledge. Once you read up on this stuff, you learn a few more things. And knowledge is power. So, taking a look at this game, I really want to go for Soligorsk. And I told you last episode, I showed you the transfer market, the salaries. I think these two teams here are the highest paid teams. like their players. Excuse me, I got a little heartburn. Whew. These two teams are the highest paid teams in the Belarus league. As far as I mean, I didn't study everybody's complete market profile, but I think these two are the highest paid. I know Soligorsk, I've mentioned it over and over, they got like five millionaires playing on their team, where other teams that, you know, like Energetik, they don't have any. I don't, well, maybe now, but anyway, this is a tough game to pick, but I'm going to have to go with, let me see one more thing. Yeah, because, you know, Dynamo Brest, they just beat Shakhtar Soligorsk in the Super Cup 1 month ago. And they beat them, they had one guy get red carded. So they beat them with 10 players on the field. And yeah, it doesn't say who was red carded, but this does say, Dynamo Brest are the form team in Belarus and should prove hard to beat at home. Their 2-0 win against Shakhtar Soligorsk in the Belarus Cup, Super Cup, despite playing most of the second half with 10 men, will give them confidence in this game. So, you know, I'm going to go with Dynamo, but they're still at a plus number. So you take them on the money line, you're still going to win. You know, they're at plus 134. It's safe bet. You're going to make out. So I'm taking that. Like, I didn't put the head-to-head. Last three head-to-head matches between these two teams. One of them went to Dynamo Brest. Sorry about that. One of them went to Dynamo Brest. Most recent one with Dynamo Brest, they won 2-1. That was the Super Cup, which I just mentioned just now. The Belarusian Premier League Super Cup tournament, they beat them 2-1. Shakhtar has none. The previous meetings before that were both draws. Back in June, we had 0-0, and then in November, we had 1-1. But most recently, you got that one there. That's another reason why I'm taking it. Now, as for the total, it's set at 2. This went over. This went under. Over. Push. And under. I'm not messing with the over. I'm not going to mess with the total. I'm just taking Dynamo Brest on the win for that game. So there you have it. To recap, I got Slavia Mozyr upsetting Bate Borisov, which means Borisov Automotive and Tractor Electronics. I love that I found that out. And I'm taking the over for that game. And over here at 12:30 tomorrow, I'm taking Dynamo Brest. And I'm not taking a total. Like I said, you can probably stream it. If not, you can go on one of the watch-along sites. There's a Hindu, a Burundi guy, like a Muslim. I don't, he's got a very thick accent. He has a watch-along with computer, like digital dots to see. And it's supposed to be satellite pictured. So it keeps continuous, like, kind of live-action flow. Take it or leave it, whatever. But there you go. Gather your information. Place your bets and cash those tickets. Now, I'm also doing the Nicaraguan games. Those should be coming up later today. Or I'll either do that show either later today or tomorrow. There's all five games are on Wednesday, I do believe. No, I'm sorry. It's split up. But anyway, I'm going to be doing some more shows, so make sure you hit the bell. If you haven't yet, hit that subscribe. Hit the thumbs up. Leave a comment. Tell me what your, I mean, I did this for Nicaragua and I got one answer. I said, what's your favorite Nicaraguan Premier League team? And one of the viewers said they like Jalapa. They happen to have lost. I lost money on that game, but whatever. What's your favorite Belarus team? I'm kind of leaning towards, I like Niemann Grodno because I don't, you know, I can always jump on board with the top dogs, but that's not my, I don't know, I'm still on the, up in the air with who I'm rooting for, who I like, but as I learned, like, this is fresh, this season and this whole league is fresh and new to me, so as I learn, I'm going to be picking up more stuff, and I'll, you know, I'm going to eventually take a team that I'm going to be rooting for. Tomorrow I'm going to be rooting for Dynamo Brest and Slavia Mozir, you know what I mean? So anyway, thanks for watching. Good luck on your bets, and I will see you next episode. Keep that homeschooling up.